Hey, what's up guys, my name is Goodmanus and I hope you had a great time in Diwali and looks like it's a great day to start off this week and also this video because today I will be discussing top 5 gaming news. Remember a game called Ghost Recon Breakpoint? Yeah, I know, I already forgot about it. Apparently, the CEO of Ubisoft himself admits that they failed the game. Yeah, better late than never, right? Ubisoft CEO himself told that the game performed very badly in terms of reviews and in terms of revenue. But he also states that it is unfair to compare this game with its predecessor of Ghost Recon Wildlands. Does he know that they actually made that game? Now, his reason of why it's unfair to compare the game with the predecessor is because the predecessor was made with optimizations and improvement that benefited the game in the end, while Breakpoint was made in 30 to 36 months and they wrongly believed that the players will be interested in a sequel for the game. Only a stupid developer would think that making a game in such a short amount of time will do any good. What happened to Ubisoft, man? They made good games. And wait, that's not it, because he himself admitted again that they knew about the technical difficulties and still they released the game. 2019 guys, 2019. So just to sum this up, Ubisoft never cared about the games, all they cared about is money. Now looking at their mistakes, they have delayed the upcoming games such as Watch Dogs Legion, Rainbow Six Quarantine, which will be coming next year from July 1st to December 31st. It's so sad to see Ubisoft developing games like these because I guess everybody knew when the trailer dropped that the game will suck. Talking about Ubisoft games, Rainbow Six Siege still going strong with its Halloween theme event. It is a limited time event which will be running till November 6th and is called Doctor's Curse, which is a reworked Frankenstein version of the theme park map in Rainbow Six Siege, where 5 exterminators will go on 5 monsters. Wait, there's no monsters in Rainbow Six Siege, right? That's right, because those 5 monsters are basically 5 operators without weapons and having Halloween skins. That does the job, right? The Exterminators is a team composed of sledges, restricted to 3 unique hammers as weapons plus trio of gadgets. The monster team is made up of Leeson, Frost, Capcan, Smoke and ELA, and they can deploy traps and can also be invisible. What happened to ELA? They just took away the beauty. Am I the only one who loves the way ELA looks? I swear to God, I will be back to you, ELA. I will be back playing as you. The goal is for exterminators to kill all monsters and for the monsters to survive the rounds. Players can pick up items from Doctor's Curse collection during the event, which has skins and charms and a free Doctor's Curse collection pack which will be given to everyone who logs in. Of course, you can buy those packs with those currencies that you have in the game. In other words, you are too chicken to play the game. Play it right now, Six Siege fan, and enjoy Halloween.
Welcome to the Doctor's Curse.
The Last of Us Part 2 has sadly been delayed, which pushed its release date from February 21st to May 2020, which is 3 months. It has been officially confirmed in Twitter that the game release date has changed, with an apology letter to the fans stating that the game will be releasing on May 29th, 2020. And the reason this decision was made because they prioritized quality over release. Unlike guys like Ubisoft. Neil Druckmann, the creative director of Naughty Dog, told in that letter that they realized that they didn't have enough time to polish the game to a level that they would call Naughty Dog quality. And so they wanted to make sure that the people get the quality that we promised to have and shown in the gameplays.
What the hell are you doing here?
You think I'd let you do this on your own?
Now I guess it's a great decision taken by Naughty Dog because to make sure that the quality is up to par is the most important concern. Considering the previous game, The Last of Us, was a gigantic success for Naughty Dog, players only want to experience the best quality possible. And since the game has complex characters and improved mechanics, it's only fitting to take more time to make the game as smooth and better as possible to have the best experience for the gamers. Similar thing also happened to a game called Doom Eternal, which pushed its release back to March 2020. This This is what I call making video games. People who are passionate and have love for the games that they're making. Unlike Ubisoft. I keep on bashing Ubisoft in this video. This is not top 5 gaming news. This is top 5 reason why I hate Ubisoft. Payday 2, a game which was released 6 years ago and still has a great player base and also are releasing DLCs every year, by the way. The publisher Starbreeze said that they will be restarting the development of this game very, very soon. But here's the catch. They are breaking a promise. That's right, a promise for Forever Free is now being broken by the creators themselves. It's been broken because they're replacing it with the paid and free content instead of only free content. 2019. And the reason for that is because they want more support. In other words, they want more money. The game is a multiplayer heist simulator which may look similar to Six Siege and was released back in 2013, but the game has been adding DLCs which kept on bringing players back and now it has a dedicated fan base. Starbreeze on the other hand thought that the player base will go down and eventually they will replace this game with a new game of theirs, but that did not happen. Surprise, surprise. Payday 2 was then joined by Payday 2 Ultimate Edition in 2017 to make the game more approachable to new players and included all DLCs, and it promised that whatever new content gets released, you guys will have it until now, which is financially not possible. Now there is a Payday 2 Legacy Edition in Steam which includes it all till 2018, but the new content won't be free, or at least some of them. If you haven't tried out Payday 2, it's actually going on 70% off right now in Steam. Go ahead and get a copy for yourself right now. Who else will be in the celebrity list of Death Stranding? It's none other than Conan O'Brien. Cool. He is a holographic O'Brien who is wearing a plushy otter on his head, which is actually a gift for the player Sam, which he can use to float down the river in otter style.
Unless you're afraid of looking too sexy.
What is this game? But this is actually not a pure cosmetic because it's used for water traveling, which means you need to get it. The game is actually getting weirder and weirder and also funnier at the same time. Nothing has been revealed when will you meet this holographic O'Brien, but if I get this game at any point in time, I will definitely go for the plushie. Death Stranding comes out on November 8th as a PS4 exclusive. Wow, I actually did cover 5 news in this very video. Amazing. Smash that like button if you really enjoyed this video and want me to do more. Subscribe to Gamer Connect now for more awesome content that we have planned coming up very soon. And follow Gamer Connect on all social media platforms and make sure you join Gamer Connect community on Facebook where you get to meet amazing gamers as well as play with them. Do check out my YouTube channel where I will be doing live streaming on games like Call of Duty for instance, and join my Discord server where you guys can chill and talk and we can play games together and you get to know me more. Thank you everyone for watching this episode. This is me, Gaming Madness, and that was gaming.